As the saying goes, if he didn't have bad luck, he'd have no luck whatsoever. Well, I caught up with David Thorne to discuss that side of his training establishment, but also, is there brightness on the horizon? Let's check it out with David. Well, David, good to catch up with you. Let's get the bad luck out of the way first. And we first up is the brilliant mare, Antonia. She's now been retired to stud.
Yeah, she had a few niggling injuries and she ended up doing a suspensory. So we pulled the pin on her and she's gone to stud, yeah.
She hasn't raced since last August. What a brilliant career, David. 26 starts, 15 wins, 7 placings. Did we ever get to see the best of her?
Oh, I think as a three-year-old, we've probably seen as good as she was. She just probably had a few little issues after that. So I think she was on the way back, but obviously things go wrong.
Three Group 1s, the New South Wales Oaks, the Gold Bracelet, and the New South Wales Breeders' Challenge three-year-old for the girls. What in particular stand out for you, David?
Probably the New South Wales Oaks. I mean, it's open to all fillies, so you get the best of the best. And she went really good. I think they broke the world record that night for a mile and a half. So, that was probably the best one. But Bathurst, she went unbelievable. They were probably her two best wins. She went 52 at Bathurst just jogging. So, she was really in a purple patch then.
Chicago Gangster showed a lot of potential winning the Tatler. Hasn't raced since June 2022. 4 stars for 2 wins and a placings. Also some news there with him.
Yeah, he done a tendon. He's actually getting rehabbed at the moment. So he's had a lot of issues as well. He's been such an unlucky horse. And I'd probably rate him second best horse I'd had in the stable behind Antonia. So it was a real shame. But we're still trying with him. I mean, he's a gelding, so you sort of got to have another crack. But if we can ever get him back. We were getting him ready for the TAB Championships, but he just didn't quite make it.
Yeah, you're in a Dominion performer. Our Money Rocks has also been on the receiving end of some bad news.
Yeah, he tied up really bad. We give him 3 months off after the Inter Dominion. We went to America, me and the owner. So we sort of decided to give him a good spell and brought him back. And he was good as gold. And then he tied up really bad and got really crooked. So, but he's back. He's probably only a couple of weeks off the trial. So hopefully we can have a good back end of the year and maybe into the Inter Dominion again. We'll just see.
He finished 10th to Loop to Fame on December 16 in that particular grand final of the Inter Dominion. His heat performances, David, were outstanding.
Yeah, he went good every start. You know, I mean, they went some 53 the last half in the final, so you're never a hope from where he drew bad and that. So, he was probably, to be fair, he was probably the only one that stretched Leap to Fame through the whole series. He sort of stretched his neck a little bit in one of the heats when he led, and we're super proud of the horse. He did a good job, and he was quite unlucky in a lot of the heats. So some of it was his own fault. He's a little bit untractable, but he went terrific all the way through.
Let's look on the bright side of things now. And first up at Redcliffe on Saturday night, Everart goes around in the Redcliffe Oaks.
Yeah, no, she's drawn good, so that's a big start. Obviously, Ricky's filly's a really good filly, Luxa Turner, and she's obviously going to be hard to beat. And Pete McMullen trialed one. It's actually a sister to Artie's Express. So they probably look the two hardest to beat, but we've got the draw on them, so that definitely helps around Redcliffe.
Yeah, Artie B. Mickey, the horse in question, won that trial by 40-plus metres off the second row. But as you said, you've got the draw.
Yeah, we have got the draw, and I think there'll be plenty of speed on, and we'll just come out as good as we can and then see what happens. But, she's a pretty nice filly. She went good here behind Minos a couple of weeks ago. So, she's a nice filly, and so she's stepping up to obviously racing them really good ones. But you've got to do it at some stage.
There's not too many driving better than Will Rickson at the moment, Dave, and he's heading north.
Yeah, he was. We were sort of undecided, depending where the drew and everything, so and how many drives he had here. But he's elected to go, so that's obviously a good sign for Everard and the owners.
You're also pleased with the fact you got some nice youngsters coming through.
Yeah, I've got a few nice two-year-olds. Been trialling one called Setup. He's just had a couple of weeks off. There was no races for him, so he's Vic Bred, and a full brother to our Money Rocks, Follow the Money. I think he's a nice horse as well. So, hopefully there's something down the track.
So things are starting to look up. Well, hopefully, Dave, all the bad luck's behind, and we can look forward to bigger and better things from the Thorn stable.
Yeah, hopefully.